Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Pharmacypedia. This is Dr. Shikha Chauhan and in this session, I'm going to discuss a very interesting topic. The topic has been taken from the subject Cosmetic Science, which is elective subject in BPharm 8th semester. And it is from Unit 3, Principles of Cosmetics Evaluation, Principles of Sebumeter. So let us try to understand and explore about the sebumeter. What is the purpose of sebumeter? What is the mode of action of sebumeter? What is the principles of sebumeter? And what are the different functions and working of the sebumeter? So if you have still not subscribed to my channel Pharmacypedia, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further updates and videos on the subject Cosmetic Science, which is a BPharm 8th semester elective subject, and getting further updates. So thank you so much for your support and please do like, share and subscribe to Pharmacypedia. So my dear friends, let us begin. So let us first try to understand what is sebumeter, what is the purpose of having the sebumeter. So sebumeter is basically the device from which we can measure the sebum. Now what is sebum? Sebum is basically the oily secretions from the sebaceous glands. And these glands start working when the adult reaches the puberty. So during that phase, there is the excess of sebum development, and we should know the excess of sebum measurement can be made by using the equipment sebumeter, which actually quantifies the concentration of the sebum. And this quantification can be done in from any part of the skin in an objective manner. So the device, basically sebumeter, was invented by the scientist Antoine Cavem, who patented it in the year 1992. So on what principles is sebumeter based? So basically we are, with the help of sebumeter, trying to analyze and evaluate the cosmetic products which helps in reducing the sebum. Now there are various cosmetic products like creams, acne, for acne treatment, whereby the people use them for a specified period of the time. Now how to measure the effectiveness of these creams, these anti-acne treatment? My dear students, you must have also seen in your life that you use a variety of creams, where you take variety of anti-acne treatments, but the problem with that is that you can't assess them. You cannot check to how much extent they have been successful. So for example, if you're taking any anti-acne treatment, ideally it should be able to reduce the sebum concentration. Now how you're going to measure this is with the help of this equipment, sebumeter. So the ideal protocol is that you measure the sebum concentration on any part of the skin, maybe your face, maybe your scalp or any other part, but directly exposing this probe. Now the probe of this equipment is known as cassette. So you basically put the cassette on the surface of the skin for a period of only 30 seconds, and within that 30 seconds you will get the result displayed on the device in terms of the milligram sebum concentration per centimeter square. So whereby you can see, and you, when you do this activity and you are taking the treatment, for example after every week, on 7th day, 14th day, 21st day, like that, you are taking the treatment and you are checking the concentration of the sebum. And if you find that the concentration of sebum is getting reduced, it simply means that your anti-acne treatment is going well. The same happens with other, to check the effectiveness, to check the evaluation of any cosmetic creams, whereby which claims to reduce the sebum concentration or which proves to be effective for the oily skin. So from the sebumeter, we are basically determining the concentration of the sebum. Because what happens, in certain disease condition, there may be excess of sebum production, or there may be excessive dryness, which can actually affect the cosmetic appearance of the skin. So people undergo a lot of skin treatments, a lot of cosmetics, which can be evaluated with the help of this equipment, sebumeter. So the estimation of the oiliness is important to decide on the correct regimen to achieve the cosmesis. Sebum is an oily secretion from the sebaceous glands. Sebum basically waterproofs and lubricates the skin and the hair of the mammals. Sebum also affects the permeability of the skin and the absorptivity of the water. It protects the skin from harmful bacteria and fungi. It limits the evaporation, permeation of pharmaceutical preparation and other active and non-active substances. So I hope you're clear with the principle part now. Now there are a number of disorders which are actually associated with the sebum and the sebaceous glands. Hence, measurement of the natural presence of the sebum is of very much interest to dermatologists and cosmeticians. So this is about the principles. Coming to the equipment, coming to the optical diagram of the sebumeter. So when we take and want to measure the sebum concentration on any body part, there are various ways by which we can do that. We can take the swabs. Now, what are these swabs? These swabs are basically they are the pads which are soaked in the organic solvent such as hexane or the water. So they absorb the oil from that particular body part, and we can measure the concentration of sebum in these swabs. Or we can, another technique which is being used is the washing of the lip. Lipid solvents. Sebum basically are the lipid solvents over areas of the skin circumscribed by the rings or the caps. So we mark a particular area with a pencil and or pen, and then every time we are measuring the concentration of sebum on that particular part after periodic interval of the time. So here, hence we can check the effectiveness of any cosmetics. We can check whether the applied cosmetics is able to produce the desired reduction in sebum or not. Or another technique may be by placing a pad of the absorbent cigarette papers or for on the surface skin and then extracting the sebum with the diethyl ether. So my dear students, there are large number of techniques for taking the samples, or you can directly place the cassette over the surface of the skin for a period of 30 seconds and you can measure the sebum concentration. So this is the equipment which I was talking about. So the black color part is known as the cassette. So the measuring head of the cassette exposes a 64 mm measuring section of the tape. For a measurement of the tape, which is transported forward by a trigger at the side of the cassette to expose a new section of the tape. So inside this black color part, cassette part, there is a tape which is being running. So this tape is used to rewind the inside the cassette. So one cassette is actually approximately used for 450 measurements. The scale from 1 to 0 on the trigger shows how much of the tape is still unused. So how much measurements can be further. So there is a marking and there is a number over that. For hygiene reasons, when exhausted, the cassette is simply replaced. A spring in the measuring head provides constant pressure on the skin. It lowers weight, makes easy. The instrument has an accuracy of ±5%. The reading of sebum may be displayed as a number or the type of the skin. For example, the reading may be in the form of the numbers or the, according to the skin, whether the skin is oily, normal, dry, like that. So basically, the sebumeter is based on the principle that when the sebum is deposited on a translucent element such as frosted glass or plastic plate or the strip, the element becomes increasingly transparent. So the greater the amount of the sebum applied, the greater is the transparency which is being produced. So the measuring head of the cassette with its special tape is placed on the skin. It is then inserted into a slot of the device. Light then passes through the sebum covered translucent element, which is further measured using a photoelectric receiver. So a microprocessor basically calculates the amount of the sebum, and the result is displayed in the unit milligram sebum per centimeter square of the scale. So hereby I have given a graph which clearly shows the comparison between two creams, emollient cream and another cream, by two colors, pink color and the blue color. So this is the way by which the sebumeter actually calculates the concentration of the sebum. You can see after every week from different body parts like forehead, the amount of the cream was applied and the reduction in the sebum was actually calculated with the help of sebumeter. This is the way by which the results of cosmetics are being evaluated out using the help of the sebumeter. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do like, share and subscribe to Pharmacypedia for getting further updates and important information content related to pharmacy. If you have any doubt or query, please feel free to write in the comment section. Thank you so much, everyone.